Hello and welcome back to Life Post Network Channel. I'm your host, Dr. Lucy Coleman. And now we are doing this series of micronutrients and supplements. And are they really necessary? Because we usually talk about all these things that the body needs and all these people that are taking supplementations and the buzz of people going out there and just getting any supplements they can to boost their immune system. And are they really necessary? Let's talk about that. Remember that you can always subscribe to my channel here and like this video so you get more up-to-date information of the release of these new things that I'm making for you, especially now that we are talking about micronutrients and supplements. And people talk about these supplements and, you know, there is all this thing about going out there and getting supplements because we really need them. But do we really, really need supplements? The main question here is if we can really get everything we need from a well-balanced diet. That's the question. And this is what is really going to help us decide if we really need supplements in order to replenish anything that the body needs. We need to know that the body has needs and daily needs. And if we don't satisfy those needs, that's like a time bomb that it will be accumulating over time. So you need to be honest with yourself. Are you really getting everything you need from a well, high, rich, nutritious diet? Most people today just don't eat a well-balanced diet. They don't. You can actually go and have a look to the American Medical Association that they made an announcement in the year 2002 where they are recommending people to take external supplementation, and I mean supplements. And the last time this organization made an announcement, that was 20 years ago, and they were saying that people actually didn't need external supplementation because they were getting everything they needed through diet. And that was great. However, that is not the case today. And this, unfortunately, is representing a huge risk for chronic illness. Low levels of vitamins A, E, C, they represent a huge risk for many chronic diseases. Vitamin E can have a huge role in protecting against the risk of prostate cancer, and this is great. Vitamin B protects the cardiovascular system, and it might also be related to protection against breast and colon cancer. And vitamin D helps with osteoporosis by strengthening the bone tissue. The nutrient contents of food, especially regarding minerals, it can fluctuate a lot regarding the growing conditions. In several countries, unfortunately, the soil is depleted completely from selenium, and it has very small amounts of calcium, magnesium, and zinc. And without mineral-rich soils, it is impossible for fruits and vegetables to contain a rich supply of nutrients. Also, artificial fertilizers have been widely used to increase the production of crop, and this is a problem. Because these fertilizers have been designed to meet the plant's needs, which is not the same needs than humans. Plants need fewer, less minerals and vitamins to grow than humans need. And this means that these plants are gonna come without those minerals and vitamins. And this will not contain the amount of nutritious properties that are really needed for humans. Furthermore, fruits and vegetables start losing their nutrient properties from the moment they are picked. And most of the fruits and vegetables we have today have been picked, stored, shipped, and probably stored again for weeks and months. Then we buy them in the store and we cook them and we get just a portion of them and we store them again. The vitamin C content of apples can fall even 2/3 after 1 to 3 months. Potatoes may have 30 milligrams of vitamin C per 100 grams when they are freshly harvested. However, each day they start losing their vitamin C content until it's practically zero. And green veggies, they suffer even more because they can lose almost all the content of vitamin C when they have been stored at room temperature. Everybody knows, for example, that orange juice is high on vitamin C. But what not many people know is that orange, they lose 30% of their content of vitamin C as soon as they are squeezed. And when you get all this orange juice in the market, they might not even have any content of vitamin C if they are not fortified. And most people don't know that a great amount of the total nutrient content in many foods exists in a form that is not bioavailable, meaning that our bodies can absorb and use it. And about 40% of the vitamin C that is left in fresh and squeezed orange juice is practically inactive. And now heat, water, light, temperature, there are other factors that can actually affect the foods. Foods go through different processes before they are canned or frozen. And this unfortunately destroys a lot of the nutrients that are present in the foods. And even the simple act of cutting vegetables and fruits, it has an impact because it will expose the food to oxygen. And this will encourage vitamins and mineral losses. Cooking foods reduces 50% of the less stable vitamins, like vitamin C. And when you serve the food, it already has a lot less content of the vitamin that initially had. And if you eat meat, the process of obtaining meat today are so invasive and profit-oriented that the meat served has almost no nutrient content and instead might even lead to diseases. Like, for example, fish that can be high in mercury and that can lead to any chronic illnesses or deteriorate your system and even cause cancer. Or these meats that are very high in antibiotics or preservatives that can actually produce cancer too. The problem is that today there is an unprecedented amount of chemicals in our food, and this can cause many problems with the nutrition that we're getting. And before we rarely hear people talking about nutrition and supplements, but today it's different. So, did we have a planet before that was amazing with providing us with highly nutritious, rich foods? Yes! Do we still have that planet today? And we are actually getting everything we need from food and all these nutritious power foods that are high in micronutrients? No. This is something amazing because even the Environmental Protection Agency has estimated that almost 60,000 tons of chemicals and waste have been buried or dumped in U.S. soil for the last years. And this is now even penetrating the water supply. Not to mention that our food has been becoming a feast filled with pesticides, preservatives, antibiotics, injected with hormones, adulterated for color, for texture, for flavor. So it has become a craziness with food. And unfortunately, we cannot completely trust that we are getting everything we need through food. People that are going through several diseases, especially chronic diseases, also have an impairment in the ingestion, digestion, absorption, or several nutrients. Some diseases can affect the digestive system, like the celiac disease, Crohn's disease, irritable bowel syndrome, lactose intolerance. And this can deplete minerals and vitamins from the body quicker and even causing more damage. We do know that nutrients are very important for a very strong immune system, especially these days that we are going through so many things with viruses and illnesses and all these chronic problems and diseases that we're going through and seem to have no end. People going through stress, strenuous exercise, emotional roller coaster, or anything that requires for them to use more energy, they will have an increased need for a proper nutrition. Also, people that are now going through certain medications, they're gonna be finding it harder to get the right nutrients. Because unfortunately, many drugs, they have interactions with vitamins and minerals. For example, tetracycline, that is an antibiotic and has an interference with the absorption of calcium, magnesium, potassium. Contraceptives, that they interfere with water-soluble vitamins. So this is why I say that this is up to you, because I'm giving you the facts regarding the bioavailability of minerals and vitamins today. And remember, today is not the same that it was many years ago, when many things were done differently. And now, unfortunately, I can say, and I have seen it with my own patients, that not all my patients are getting everything they need through diet alone, even when it's a nutritious, rich diet. I do recommend a nutritious, rich diet. However, I am the one that always says that supplementation is key. Because we need to make sure that our metabolism is getting what we need, and actually the body is getting what it needs in terms of strengthening the immune system. That the immune system is key right now. But as I say, I leave this up to you to decide what is the best thing, because you are the only one that knows what is the best thing for you. I'm just giving you facts. If you're perfectly healthy and have any issues, then fine, you might not need supplements. If instead you have a health condition, or you are at high risk for a disease because of a family history, or because you have a history of chronic illness yourself, or anything that has been affecting you or your lifestyle, then you should be considering getting all these nutrients that your body needs right now. Because I would say that almost anyone today can benefit from any type of supplement. And this is what I want to say. Remember that you can always follow me in this channel. I'm going to be making more videos regarding supplementations and supplements, so you can make your decision of what you would like to do with your body. But the most important thing is here that you need to get the knowledge in order to fight any chronic illnesses, prevent it or fight it or heal it if you are going through that right now. Because my purpose right now is to focus on chronic illnesses and for you to feel a lot better. Take care, and I will see you very soon. Bye bye.